Hello and welcome to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. Today we are going to solve a coding problem called valid palindrome. Here is the problem. Given a string S, return true if it is a palindrome and false otherwise. Only consider alphanumeric characters and ignore cases. Okay, this is the problem statement. Next, let's analyze the problem and see how to solve it. Input of our program is a string. Output is true or false. Output is true if string is a palindrome and false otherwise. And also, a palindrome string is a string that reads the same backward as forward. A string is considered a palindrome if reversing it gives the same string. Here are the few examples. A string is this, and ignoring non-alphanumeric characters and case sensitivity, it is a palindrome string. If we reverse the alphanumeric characters, we'll get the same string. Next, when designing a valid palindrome check program, there are number of constraints and considerations to take into account, which ensures that the program works efficiently and correctly under different scenarios. Let's go through the common constraints and best practices. First one is ignore non-alphanumeric characters. String might contain space, punctuators, or other non-alphanumeric characters, and they should not be considered when checking if the string is a palindrome. And case sensitivity, uppercase and lowercase letters should be treated as the same. In our program, an empty string and a string with only non-alphanumeric characters are considered palindromes. Okay, so next let's see how to write the program with an example. Here we have a string. And to solve this problem, we'll use two-pointer approach. We'll take two pointers, left and right. Left pointer points to the characters at the 0th index. And the right pointer points to the character at the last index of string. These pointers move towards each other, comparing characters from both ends until they meet or cross. First, check the character at the left pointer. If it is not alphanumeric character, increment the pointer and skip this character. We'll only consider alphanumeric characters, right? And here it is not alphanumeric character, so skip it. Move the pointer to next character. Next character is this. Check whether this character is an alphanumeric character. Here, no. It is not an alphabet or a number. So skip it. Move the pointer to the next character. Here next character is space, so ignore it. It is not an alphanumeric character. Move the pointer to the next character. Here A. A is an alphabet. It is an alphanumeric character, so stop. Next, check the character at the right pointer. It is an alphabet, so stop. After skipping non-alphanumeric characters, compare the characters at the left pointer with the character at the right pointer. And convert both to lowercase to ensure the comparison is case insensitive. If the character do not match, return false. And if they match, it means this part of the string is still a potential palindrome. So move the left pointer one step to the right and the right pointer one step to the left and continue the comparison. Here A and A, and we'll convert both the characters to lowercase. So we'll get A, and it is a match. So increment left pointer by 1, decrement right pointer by 1. Here in the left pointer, the character is a space. So space is not an alphanumeric character. So skip it and move the pointer to the next character. Now the next character is M. It is an alphabet. So stop. Next, let's check the character at the right pointer. It is an alphabet. So stop. Now compare both the characters. First convert the characters to lowercase and compare. Here it is a match, so increment left pointer by 1, decrement right pointer by 1. Now in the left pointer, character is an alphabet, so stop, check the character at the right pointer, it is also an alphabet. So compare both the characters, first convert the characters to lowercase and compare. Here it is a match, so increment left pointer by 1, decrement right pointer by 1. Now in the left pointer, character is this, it is an alphabet. And in the right pointer, character is an alphabet. So compare the characters, convert it to lowercase and compare. Here it is a match. So increment left by 1, decrement right by 1. Here in the left pointer, character is a space. It is not an alphanumeric character. So skip it. Move the pointer to the next character. Next character is here colon. And colon is not an alphanumeric character. So skip it. Move the pointer to the next character. Next character is space. And here you can see left pointer is equal to right pointer. Both the pointer is pointing to the same character. So now we need to stop. We need to compare the character from the both the ends until they meet or cross. Left pointer is equal to right pointer now. So stop. Now after comparing every characters, we can conclude that it is a palindrome string. So we'll return the result true. And in this example, here you can see left pointer first points to the character at the 0th index. It is not an alphanumeric character. Move the pointer to the next character. It is an alphabet. And here right pointer points to an alphabet. And now convert both the character to lowercase and compare. It is not a match. So you can return false saying that it is not a palindrome. Okay, so this is how we can find a string is palindrome or not using two-point approach. Next, let's write the program. In the Python file, first let's define a function. Function name is palindrome and parameter is yes, that is the string. This function will return true or false, a boolean value, and here yes is a string. Next, here we are using two-pointer approach. So let's create two pointers, left and right. Left points to the character at the 0th index and right points to the character at the last index. So for that, I'll use length of s minus 1. Index will start from 0. So the last index will be length of s minus 1. Here you can see the example. Next, we need to first check the character at the left pointer. We need to see whether that character is an alphanumeric character or not. To do that, I'll use alnum string method. It will return true or false. I'll use if condition and I'll check to get that character dot is alnum like this. And here I'll use if not. If the character is not an alphanumeric character, then what I need to do? I need to increment left pointer by 1. That is, we need to move the pointer to the left side. To the next character, so left equal to left plus 1. And also what we need to do is, after changing the left value, we need to check whether left is less than right. When left pointer and right pointer meets or cross, we need to stop. So we need to use that condition first. So here I'll use a while loop and I'll check while left is less than right, then only I'll check this condition. When left is less than right, I'll check whether that character present in the left pointer is alphanumeric character or not. If it is not, then increment left by 1. And also I'll use continue here, continue statement. What it will do is, it will stop the execution of next statements. Control will go to the beginning of the loop. It will re-evaluate this condition, while loop condition. We'll again check whether left is less than right. Here we'll modify or change the value of left pointer, right? That's why I need to check whether left is still less than right. If it is not, then we can stop. If it is yes, then continue to check whether the character is an alphanumeric character or not. Then after doing this, we need to check the character at the right pointer. So next I'll check whether the character at the right pointer is an alphanumeric character or not. If it is not, then decrement right by 1. And also use continue, that is, we need to check whether left is less than right, this condition. That's why I'll use continue. If both these conditions are false, if both the characters are alphanumeric character, then we need to compare that two characters. Before comparing the characters, let's convert the characters to lowercase. We'll convert both the characters to lowercase and we'll compare them like this. If they are not equal, then return false. If this condition becomes false, if the characters match, then increment left by 1, decrement right by 1, like this. Now again, we need to go here and we need to check whether left is less than right. then we need to check this condition whether the character is an alphanumeric character. If it is alphanumeric characters, then compare the characters. We need to do this again and again until left becomes equal to right or greater than right. Now, if the loop completes without stopping, it means the string is a palindrome. So here, return true. We are done with the function definition. Alright, next, let's call this function. First, let's take string. I'll use if condition. We'll print like this. If this function returns true, then we'll print this message. Else, we'll print this message. Let's save this and execute this. It is a palindrome. Next, let's take another save and execute. It is not a palindrome. You can take like this also. It is a palindrome. Okay, so this is about valid palindrome program. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.